Situated upon the southern banks of the mighty Brahmaputra River, in the heart of the capital city of Guwahati in Assam, Cotton University, established by the Cotton University Act 2017, has its genesis in Cotton College, the premier institution of higher education, established way back in 1901. True to its motto, the institution has gifted the nation and the world individuals who have made outstanding contribution in spheres that embrace not merely academics, but every direction of life in general, including culture and politics. In urban areas, Cotton University continues to uphold the glorious legacy of the past and has today blossomed into a vibrant institution consisting of more than 30 academic departments. With a student intake of more than 5,000, the university conducts classes not only for PG and PhD programs, but also for undergraduate students besides the higher secondary classes, which continue to remain a part of the university till date. Spread across a sprawling campus, the university is home to enthusiastic faculty who strive towards excellence through their distinguished academic pursuits, and hard-working and dedicated staff who has made significant contribution in its growth and development. The university caters to a student community, young and promising, from diverse socio-cultural backgrounds, who entered its hallowed campus with dreams in their eyes. Today, on the day of its first convocation, the Cotton family stands united in its effort towards bringing the dreams of its students into fruition while facing every challenge brought about by changes in the global education scenario. Cotton University continues its quest for excellence with renewed vigor, enhanced sense of responsibility and accountability towards every stakeholder, and envisions a world-class institution in the days to come.
Namaskar, a very good morning. The first convocation of Cotton University is about to begin in the virtual mode in a short while from now. It is indeed a great privilege to extend a warm welcome to His Excellency, the Governor of Assam, Honorable Chancellor, Cotton University, Professor Jagdish Mukhi. We are honored to have amongst us our chief guest for the occasion, Honorable Chief Minister of Assam, Dr. Himanta Biswa Sarma, the guest of honor, Honorable Education Minister of Assam, Dr. Ranoj Pegu, the convocation speaker, Professor Vinod Kumar Jain, Honorable Vice Chancellor, Tezpur University, Professor Bhavesh Chandra Goswami, Honorable Vice Chancellor, Cotton University, and Professor Digonto Kumar Das, Registrar, Cotton University. we extend warm greetings to all distinguished guests, eminent academicians, retired and present members of the faculty, alumni of the university, dear students, and all well-wishers of Cotton family who are joining us on the virtual platform for the occasion.
It's now time for the national anthem that shall be followed by the state anthem. May I request all to kindly rise in their seats.
Jana Gana Mana Adhinayaka Jaya Hai Bharat Bhagya Vidhata Punjab Sindh Gujarat Maratha Dravida Utkala Vanga Vindhya Himachala Yamuna Ganga Uchala Jaladhi Taranga तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मांगे गाहे तव जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे
May I now request Professor Digonto Kumar Das, Registrar, Cotton University, to take the proceedings forward.
I request Honorable Chancellor to declare the first convocation of Cotton University open.
I declare the first convocation of Cotton University open.
May I now request Professor Bhavesh Chandra Goswami, Honorable Vice Chancellor, Cotton University, to present the welcome address and the report.
His Excellency, the Governor of Assam and Honorable Chancellor of the University, Professor Jagdish Mukhiji, Dr. Himanta Biswa Sarma, Honorable Chief Minister of Assam, Professor V.K. Jain, Vice-Chancellor of Tezpur University, Dr. Ronos Pegu, Honorable Education Minister of Assam, Professor Das, Register, all the deans, faculty members, officers, staff, and my dear graduating students and friends of Cotton. Today is a very important day for all of us in Cotton University as it marks the first convocation of a historic institution that has withstood the test of time. Cotton upgraded itself from a 116-year-old college to a full-fledged university in the year 2017 in order to establish a teaching and research unitary and residential university. This is perhaps the most awaited time of the year as the first few batches of our students will graduate from Cotton University today, carrying with them their individual hopes and dreams and those of their families, friends, and communities. The COVID-19 pandemic may have hindered and prolonged our wait to celebrate this achievement, but nonetheless, today marks the beginning of a new path towards the well-deserved success of our dear students in the years to come. With a heritage that goes back more than 100 years, Curtin, the premier seat of higher learning in Northeast India, unequivocally occupies a proud place among the institutions of its kind in the northeastern part of the country. Contemporaneous with Murarisan College of Sylhet, now in Bangladesh, of undivided India under British rule, the then Curtin College came into existence on 27th May 1901 through the untiring efforts of illustrious sons of the soil like late Manikchandra Borua, Rai Bahadur Bhuvan Ram Das, and Raja Prabhat Chandra Borua, backed by the unstinted support of the intelligentsia of the region of that time. Curtin University, in its journey from a college for excellence to a university established on 1st June 2017, has produced a long list of alumni, particularly from all the seven sisters of Northeast who have excelled in his or her field of work, be it in science, medicine, literature, art, culture, music, drama, politics, or any other discipline. It has a never-ending list of great achievers, statesmen, women leaders, administrative officers, and innovators such as Lokapriya Gopinath Bordoloi, Dr. Bhupen Hazarika, Birendra Kumar Bhattacharya, Dr. Mamoni Roysham Goswami, Hem Borua, Homen Borgohain, and in more recent times, Justice Ranjan Gogoi, Honorable Chief Minister, Dr. Himanta Biswa Sarma, Dr. Jitendra Goswami, and Rima Das are a few of the names that have brought laurels to the state by excelling in their work. My dear students, now it is your turn to follow in their footsteps. You may not realize this immediately, but the 3 to 5 years that you spent in this particular premier institute of learning have prepared you for a huge number of challenges that you will face in your life. The knowledge and exposure you received from the faculty through classrooms, labs, and various other interactions will help you in establishing yourself in any job, service, activism, organizational, or entrepreneurial endeavors that you commit yourself to. Even if your ideal job is not immediately available, there are many unexplored opportunities ready to welcome you. The internet provides a new virtual world of knowledge and opens the door to a sea of new opportunities. The vision of Curtin University is to provide quality holistic education to its students to develop foundational, employable, and entrepreneurial skills among the students, to contribute to knowledge via cutting-edge frontline research while upholding the highest standards of ethics and public accountability, and to provide new and challenging opportunities to all students, faculty, and staff. This university aims to become a world-class university by excelling in teaching, research, and interdisciplinary education and knowledge and skill development. Additionally, the university also aims to give the equal attention to sports and fitness. Playing sports inculcates team spirit and develops strategic and analytical thinking, leadership skill, goal setting, and risk taking. The university is trying to develop fit and healthy students who in turn will build an equally healthy society and a strong nation. This philosophy of synergistic development of fitness and intellect aligns perfectly with Cotton University's motto of Pramottana Vedabhyam, which may be interpreted as, quote, remaining indifferent to obstacles or hurdles that may come along the way. One must pursue knowledge with concentration and perseverance, unquote. In order to keep pace with the demands of the changing times, the university, in its first 4 years of existence, had started various new courses and programs to facilitate our students and provide them with a quality platform for learning. This includes new departments such as law, library and information science, mass communication and journalism, new undergraduate courses such as psychology, sociology, liberal arts, a new center for women's studies, and a new center for language, culture and art, and many more. I am particularly proud of the new BA program for sportspersons, which we launched in 2020 and 21. This uniquely designed undergraduate program is the first of its kind in the region. Designed as a general bachelor's degree program, this course holistically attempts to cater the needs of career sportspersons, which also encourages them to pursue higher education without hampering their illustrious sports career. Olympic medalist Lavlina Borgohain, Asian Games medalist Hima Das, and Indian cricketer Riyan Parag are some of the names enrolled for this course. Incidentally, of the Olympians that the state of Assam has ever produced, two, namely Talimara Nau and Dipankar Bhattacharji, are alumni from our institution, while Lavlina Borgohain, who has made the nation proud in Tokyo 2020 Olympics with a bronze medal, is a present student of Cotton University. With the onset of COVID-19 pandemic, there has been a paradigm shift in the teaching-learning process of the university. Classroom teaching has been replaced by online virtual classrooms. This crisis has forced us to find alternatives to face-to-face instruction. As a result, various online modes of learning have been used by the teachers and students on an unprecedented scale. I must congratulate all my faculty members and students for adapting well to this change and for surmounting all the initial challenges faced by them. Today, I can proudly announce that we are among the first few institutes to have successfully conducted online examinations for our students in this part of the country. Cotton University is ready for the hybrid system of teaching learning as suggested by University Grants Commission and the new education policy. Remember that the Cotton is an educational institution which in its lifespan has seen two pandemics separated by more than a century, the 1918 Spanish flu and the 2020-21 COVID-19. We survived then, we will survive now, and we will survive every future challenges. I like to remind myself of the old proverb that, quote, what does not kill you makes you stronger. I repeat, I quote, what does not kill you makes you stronger, unquote. I believe that once the humanity emerges from this phase, we will be stronger in our mindset as a result of all the systems we are building to combat this pandemic. We will be stronger in terms of our will to find alternative ways to carry out our essential duties, including education, even in the presence of a massive disruption. Despite our meager resources, the university has tried to upgrade the departmental infrastructure and accommodation in the last 4 years, which has resulted in a manifold increase in the number of externally funded research projects, as evidenced by good publications in high impact factor journals. Additionally, the university faculty have also been able to apply for a number of larger projects, which will lead to a proper research environment by updating the labs with new instruments in near future. To upgrade the academic environment, the university was able to appoint more than 60 bright and young faculty members in the last 2 years across the various departments. Looking ahead, the university is eager to implement the new education policy 2020 as soon as the final guidelines are approved by University Grants Commission and the state government. We have already started taking steps in this direction by instituting credit transfer policy, certain selected interdisciplinary courses at this unitary university has a well-established set of basic and fundamental science, social science, and language department imparting both undergraduate and postgraduate courses. I must thank the Cotton team, including all faculty members, officers, staff, and all well-wishers for their constant involvement. Their support ensured a smooth sail in our first 4 years as a unitary university. Today, I would like to take this opportunity to thank the Honorable Governor of Assam, His Excellency Professor Mukhi, and also Honorable Chief Minister of Assam and alumni of Cotton, Dr. Hemanta Biswa Sarma, for your continued guidance and support to the university. We are hopeful that under your guidance, we will be able to fulfill the dreams of building a university par excellence in this part of the country. I would like to acknowledge the efforts of my faculty members and staff for making this virtual convocation ceremony a success, and conclude my speech by quoting words of William Wordsworth. Quote, "Life is divided into three terms, that which was, which is, and which will be. Let us learn from the past to profit from the present, and from the present to live better in the future," unquote. So let us keep learning and growing together. Finally, I congratulate all the graduating students and their parents for their support and guidance to their wards in this journey till now. Joy Ayokham, thank you, Joy Hind.
Now, we move forward for the proceedings of award of the degrees.
Now I request the Honorable Chancellor to proceed for award of degrees to the eligible candidates.
By virtue of the authority vested on me as Chancellor of the University, I shall now award degrees. Let the candidates for the award of the degrees be presented.
I urge upon the deans of the faculties to present the candidates of the departments under the respective faculties for award of the degrees to the Honorable Chancellor.
We shall now proceed to the virtual award of the degrees. To begin with, may I now request Professor Kalyan Das, Dean, Faculty of Earth Sciences, to present the candidates of the faculty.
I urge upon the candidates for the degree of Master of Science in Geography and Geology in the years 2017, 2018, 2019 under the Faculty of Earth Sciences to rise in their seats. I present to you, sir, in the virtual mode, candidates who have been found fit for the award of the degree of Master of Science in Geography and Geology in the years 2017, 2018, 2019, and pray that they be admitted. Academic session 2015 to 2017, Geography 2017, Priyanka Dutta and others. Geology 2017, Gaurav Hajarika and others. Academic session 2016-2018, Geography 2018, Akanksha S. Bhargava and others. Geology 2018, Manas Pratim Gogoi and others. Academic session 2017-19, Geography 2019, Mrilanidhi Devi and others. Geology 2019, Anyoha Datta Hazarika and others.
Admitted as prayed.
I urge upon the candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Science in Geography and Geology under the School of Earth Sciences in the years 2017, 2018, 2019 to rise in their seats. I present to you, sir, candidates in the virtual mode who have found fit for the award of the degree of Bachelor of Science in Geography and Geology of the years 2017, 2018, 2019, and pray that they be admitted. Academic session 2014-2017, Geography 2017, Sayada Rizwana Yasmin and Abhrajyoti Harma and others. Geology 2017, Sara Imran and others. Academic session 2015-2018, Geography 2018, Bachelor of Arts, Sahil Chaudhary, Neha Kumari Prasad and others. Geology 2018, Saini Samin and others. Academic session 2016-2019, Geography 2019, Bachelor of Arts, Gyanashree Hoikia and others. Geography 2019, Bachelor of Science, Uhanup Bhuya and others. Geology 2019, Changyukta Setia and others.
Admitted as prayed.
We shall now proceed to the award of degrees in the Faculty of Human and Social Sciences. May I now request Dr. Shantanu Chakraborty, Dean, Faculty of Human and Social Sciences, to present the candidates of the faculty.
I urge upon the candidates for the degree of Master of Arts in Anthropology, Archaeology, Economics, Education, History, Philosophy, Political Science, Psychology, and Sociology of the years 2017, 2018, and 2019 to rise in their seats. I present to you, sir, in the virtual mode, candidates who have been found fit for the award of the degree of Master of Arts in Anthropology, Archaeology, Economics, Education, History, Philosophy, Political Science, Psychology, and Sociology of the years 2017, 2018, 2019, and pray that they be admitted. Academic session 2015-2017, Anthropology 2017, Elina Ahmed and Namrata Medhi and others. Economics 2017, Topoti Saha and others. Education 2017, Anjum Sahidullah and others, History, 2017, Roja Ahmed and others, Philosophy, 2017, Sandromita Das and others, Political Science, 2017, Rosmi Rekha Bora and others, Psychology, 2017, Topati Borua and others, Sociology, 2017, Kajol Kusum Devi and others, Academic Session, 2016-2018, Anthropology, 2018, Sehnaz Begum and others, Archaeology, 2018, Shreya Sharma and others, Economics, 2018, Paramita Folia and others, Education, 2018, Deep Sikha Bharadwaj and others, History, 2018, Onukhuya Borua and others, Philosophy, 2018, Papori Bordloi and others, Political Science, 2018, Kankita Horma and others, Psychology, 2018, Sumitra Das and others, Sociology, 2018, Onkur Gogoi and others, Academic Session, 2017-2019, Anthropology, 2019, Farzina Mehjabin and others, Archaeology, 2019, Dorsana Deka and others, Economics, 2019, Sondasmita Deka and others, Education, 2019, Bonita Kolita and others, History, 2019, Wajida Ahmed and others, Philosophy 2019, Bhaswati Talukdar and others, Political Science 2019, Sarmistha Chakraborty and others, Psychology 2019, Pratima Ekka and others, Sociology 2019, Eva Kolita and others.
Admitted as prayed.
I urge upon the candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Arts in Anthropology, Economics, Education, History, Philosophy, and Political Science of the years 2017, 2018, and 2019 to rise in their seats. I present to you candidates in the virtual mode who have been found fit for the award of degree of Bachelor of Arts in Anthropology, Economics, Education, History, Philosophy, and Political Science of the years 2017, 2018, and 2019, and pray that they be admitted. Academic Session 2014-2017, Anthropology, 2017, Borosa Roy and others, BSc Anthropology, Pauthenglang Singsong and others, Economics, 2017, Kritika Das and others, BSc Economics, Jigyasa Sandilyo and others, Education, 2017, Monita Kolita and others, History, 2017, Kirtana Bordoloi and others, Philosophy, 2017, Devajit Chakraborty and others, Political Science, 2017, Krisangi Soikya and others, Academic Session, 2015-2018, Anthropology, 2018, Ongana Goswami and others, BSc Anthropology, Lolita Nath and others, Economics 2018, Karnika Bhattacharya and others, BSc Economics, Swapnalina Padgiri and others, Education 2018, Kaibwasri Hazarika and others, History 2018, Dorsana Bhuya and others, Philosophy 2018, Pompey Kolita and others. Political Science 2018, Megha Choudhury and others. Academic Session 2016-2019, Anthropology 2019, Sobita Devi and others. BSc Anthropology, Iman Ghosh and others. Economics 2019, Osim Nath and others. BSc Economics, Onnesa Soikia and others. Education 2019, Gautami Bejborua and others. History 2019, Bhavana Deka and others. Philosophy 2019, Bithika Ray and others. Political Science 2019, Diksha Bordoloi and others.
Admitted as prayed.
I urge upon the candidates for the PG Diploma in Mass Communication and Journalism of the years 2017 and 18 to rise in their seats. I present to you candidates in the virtual mode who have been found fit for the award of PG Diploma in Mass Communication and Journalism of the years 2017 and 18 and pray that they be admitted. 2017, Supriya Bora and others. 2018, Jutimani Kolita and others.
Admitted as prayed.
We shall now proceed to the award of the degrees in the Faculty of Languages, Literature and Linguistics. May I request Professor Phukon Chandra Basu Matari, Dean, Faculty of Languages, Literature and Linguistics, to present the candidates of the faculty.
I urge upon the candidates for the degree of Master of Arts in Arabic, Assamese, Bengali, Bodo, English, Hindi, Persian, and Sanskrit in the years 2017, 18, 19, to raise in their seats. I present to you, sir, candidates in the virtual mode who have been found fit for the award of the degree of Master of Arts in Arabic, Assamese, Bengali, Hindi, English, Persian, and Sanskrit in the years 2017, 18, 19, and pray that they be admitted. Academic Session 2015-17, Subject Arabic 2017, Shafiquzzaman Mustafa and others, Assamese 2017, Meenakshi Barua and others, Bengali 2017, Kia Loskar and others, English 2017, Shehnaz Soyeda Sultana and others, Hindi 2017, Risa Somua and others, Persian 2017, Minazul Haq and others, Sanskrit 2017, Wajasina Parasar and others, Academic Session 2016-18, Arabic 2018, Minazul Rahman and others, Assamese 2018, Risa Gogoi and Borsarani Boiso and others, Bengali 2018, Susitra Bera and others, English 2018, Sikha Chaudhuri and Gitika Talukdar and others, Hindi 2018, Poidul Islam and others, Persian 2018, Samim Ahmed Loskar and others, Sanskrit 2018, Gauri Smita Borua and others. Academic Session 2017-19, Arabic 2019, Murtaza Hussein and others, Assamese 2019, Fancy Sutia and Purando Gogoi and others, Bengali 2019, Surabhi Devnath and others, English 2019, Abhilasha Phukon and Mintunath and others, Hindi 2019, Neelakshi Pawe and others, Persian 2019, Selig Ahmed Loskar and others, Sanskrit 2019, Prajjalita Chakraborty and others.
Admitted as prayed.
Bachelor of Arts. I urge upon the candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Arts in Arabic, Assamese, Bengali, Bodo, English, Hindi, Persian and Sanskrit in the years 2017-18-19 to raise India seats. I present to you, sir, candidates in the virtual mode who have been found fit for the award of the degree of Bachelor of Arts in Arabic, Assamese, Bengali, English, Hindi, Persian, and Sanskrit in the years 2017-18-19, and pray that they be admitted. Academic session 2014-17, Assamese 2017, Fancy Sutia and Kritiman Choudhury and others. Bengali 2017, Devashri Chakraborty and others. English 2017, Priyoshna Day and others. Hindi 2017, Himashri Nath and others. Sanskrit 2017, Joyshree Das and others. Academic session 2015-18, Arabic 2018, Khalid Bin Saif and others. Assamese 2018, Dimpi Das and others. Bengali 2018, Mridul Nath and others. English 2018, Ananya Ghosh and others. Hindi 2018, Priyodarshini Das and others. Sanskrit 2018, Himandri Sharma and others. Academic session 2016-19, Arabic 2019, Mohammad Suruj Jamal and others. Assamese 2019, Murchana Bhattacharya and others. Bengali 2019, Raju Sutradhar and others. English 2019, Rini Sultana and others. Hindi 2019, Jumi Choudhury and others. Sanskrit 2019, Risha Rani Sharma Kashyap and others.
Admitted as prayed.
We shall now proceed to the award of the degrees in the Faculty of Life Sciences. May I request Professor Ganesh Chandra Wari, Dean, Research and Development, to present the candidates of the Faculty of Life Sciences.
I urge upon the candidate for the degree of Master of Science in Botany, Environmental Biology and Wildlife Sciences, Molecular Biology and Biotechnology, and Zoology in the year 2017-2018-2019 for rise in their seats. I present to you, sir, candidate in the virtual mode who have been found fit for the award of the degree of Master of Science in Botany, Environmental Biology, Wildlife Sciences, Molecular Biology and Biotechnology, and Zoology in the years 2017-2018-2019, and pray that they be admitted. Academic session 2015-2017, Botany 2017, Rajesh Dev Sarkar and others, Zoology 2017, Pushpanjali Khan and others, Academic session 2016-2018, Botany 2018, Runa Rahman and others, Environmental Biology and Wildlife Sciences 2018, Omblan Aditya Gutsami and others, Molecular Biology and Biotechnology 2018, Niharika Thakuria and others, Zoology 2018, Susmita Chakraborty and others, Academic Session 2017-2019, Botany 2019, Sagarika Pal and others, Environmental Biology and Wildlife Sciences 2019, Manu Jyoti Talukdar and others, Molecular Biology and Biotechnology 2019, Pushpa Sharma and others, Zoology 2019, Risha Sharma and others.
Admitted as prayed.
Bachelor of Science. I urge upon the candidate for the degree of Bachelor of Science in Botany, Environmental Biology and Wildlife Sciences, Molecular Biology and Biotechnology and Zoology in the year 2017-2018-2019 to rise in their seats. I present to you, sir, candidate in the virtual mode who have been found fit for the award of the degree of Bachelor of Science in Botany, Environmental Biology and Wildlife Sciences, Molecular Biology and Biotechnology and Zoology in the years 2017, 2018, 2019, and pray that they be admitted. Academic Session 2014-2017, Botany 2017, Lipika Borua and Sagarika Pal and others, Biotechnology 2017, Binita Dam and others, Zoology 2017, Nikita Jain and others. Academic Session 2015-2018, Botany 2018, Salini Deka and others, Biotechnology 2018, Arnob Saha and others, Zoology 2018, Omama Farnas and others. Academic Session 2016-2019, Botany 2019, Sutasri Nath and others, Biotechnology 2019, Saurabh Sengupta and others, Zoology 2019, Diksha Kalita and Pranami Bhardwaj Barah and others.
Admitted as prayed.
We shall now proceed to the award of the degrees in the Faculty of Physical, Chemical and Mathematical Sciences. May I request Professor Moushumi Ganguly, Dean, Faculty of Physical, Chemical and Mathematical Sciences, to present the candidates of the faculty.
I urge upon the candidates for the degree of Master of Science in Chemistry, Computer Science and IT, Mathematics, Physics, Statistics, and Master of Computer Applications in the years 2017, 18, and 2019 to rise in their seats. I present to you, sir, candidates in the virtual mode who have been found fit for the award of the degree of Masters of Science in Chemistry, Computer Science and IT, Mathematics, Physics, Statistics, and Master of Computer Applications in the years 2017, 2018, 2019, and pray that they be admitted. Academic Session 2015 to 2017, Chemistry 2017, Alpana Borua and others, Mathematics 2017, Hirokjyoti Borman and others, Physics 2017, Upahana Bardoloi and others, Statistics 2017, Shapon Bhattacharji and others, MCA 2017, Abhijit Bonik and others. Academic Session 2016 to 2018, Chemistry 2018, Sakira Tabassum Bora and others, Mathematics 2018, Dhanji Deka and others, Physics 2018, Sinus Parveen and others, Statistics 2018, Shimantika Chakraborty and others, MCA 2018, Khumen Chetia and others. Academic Session 2017 to 2019, Chemistry 2019, Gargi Datta and others. Mathematics 2019, Saurabh Kumar Saha and others. Physics 2019, Pinaki Datta and others. Statistics 2019, Sayasri Sharma and others. MCA 2019, Shrutimala Deka and others.
Admitted as prayed.
Bachelor of Science. I urge upon the candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Science in Chemistry, Computer Science and IT, Mathematics, Physics, Statistics, and BCA in the years 2017-2018, 2019 to rise in their seats. I present to you, sir, candidates in the virtual mode who have been found fit for the award of the degree of Bachelor of Science in Chemistry, Computer Science and IT, Mathematics, Physics, Statistics, and Bachelor of Computer Applications in the years 2017, 2018, 2019, and pray that they be admitted. academic session 2014 to 2017, chemistry 2017, Onubrata Chakraborty and others, computer science and IT 2017, Pallavi Goswami and others, mathematics 2017, Saurabh Kumar Saha and others, mathematics BA 2017, Shubham Singhania and others, physics 2017, Kallol De and others, statistics 2017, Kasturi Kashyap and others, BCA 2017, Joy Krishna Das and others. Academic session 2015 to 2018, chemistry 2018, Ruby Moral and others, computer science and IT 2018, Deep Pratim Chakraborty and others, mathematics 2018, Abhishek Goswami and others, mathematics BA 2018, Saswati Mahanta and others, physics 2018, Upama Das and others, statistics 2018, Nilanjan Devnath and others, BCA 2018, Shubham De and others. Academic session 2016 to 2019, chemistry 2019, Shreyashi Shom and others, computer science and IT 2019, Angshuman Sinha and others, mathematics 2019, Anushuya Boishya and others, mathematics BA 2019, Wasim Rahman Shraikia and others, physics 2019, Jessica Ghatak and others, statistics 2019, Bhargav Kakoti and others, BCA 2019, Debayon Chakraborty and others.
Admitted as PRED.
PG Diploma in Computer Applications. I urge upon the candidates for the PG Diploma in Computer Applications of the years 2017, 2018, 2019 to rise in their seats. I present to you candidates in the virtual mode who have been found fit for the award of PG Diploma in Computer Applications of the years 2017, 2018, and 2019, and pray that they be admitted. Computer Application 2017, Sabnam Sultana Ahmed and others, 2018, Debankur Shaikia and others, 2019, Orko Jyoti Chakraborty and others.
Admitted as PRED.
May I request Registrar Cotton University to proceed for signing of the convocation register.
I request the Honorable Chancellor and the Vice Chancellor to sign the convocation register of the university. Let us now proceed towards the award of university gold medals. As the ceremony is being held in the virtual mode, the gold medals shall be received by Dhanji Deka, postgraduate from the Department of Mathematics for the year 2018, and Bhargav Kakoti, undergraduate student from the Department of Statistics for the year 2019,
who shall be representing the gold medalists in the various subjects in the UG, PG and diploma programs of the university. May I now request Registrar, Cotton University, to proceed for the award of university gold medals.
The university gold medals won each for postgraduate, undergraduate, diploma program is awarded annually to the student who secures highest CGPA in his or her regular batch of program of study. Gold medal in PG is awarded to Dhanjit Deka, Department of Mathematics for 2018. Gold medal in UG is awarded to Bhargav Kakoti, Department of Statistics for 2019. We shall now continue with the award of gold medals for all other awardees. Faculty of Arts Sciences, MSc in Geography and Geology of the years 2017-2018-2019. Geography 2017, Priyanka Dotto. Geology 2017, Gaurav Hazarika. Geography 2018, Akanksha S. Bhargav. Geology 2018, Manoh Pratim Gogoi. Geography 2019, Minalini Devi. Geology 2019, Onneha Dotto Hazarika. BSc in Geography and Geology of the years 2017-2018-2019. Geography 2017, Seda Rizwana Yasmin. Geography 2017, Abhrajyoti Sharma. Geology 2017, Sara Imran. Geography 2018, BA Neha Kumari Prasad. Geography 2018, BSc Sahil Choudhury. Geology 2018, Saini Samim. Geography 2019, BA Gyanashri Hoikia. Geography 2019, BSc Kusanob Phuya. Geology 2019, Sanjukta Setia. Faculty of Human and Social Sciences, MA in Anthropology, Archaeology, Economics, Education, History, Philosophy, Political Science, Psychology, and Sociology of the years 2017-2018-2019. Anthropology 2017, Namrata Medhi. Anthropology 2017, Elina Ahmed. Economics 2017, Topoti Saha. Education 2017, Anjum Sahidullah. History 2017, Roza Ahmed. Philosophy 2017, Sandamita Das. Political Science 2017, Rosmi Rekha Bora. Psychology 2017, Topoti Borua. Sociology 2017, Kajol Kusum Devi. Anthropology 2018, Shahnaz Begum. Archaeology 2018, Shreya Sharma. Economics 2018, Paromita Phalia. Education 2018, Deepshikha Bharadwaj. History 2018, Anuhuya Borua. Philosophy 2018, Papuri Bordoloi. Political Science 2018, Kankhita Sharma. Psychology 2018, Sumitra Das. Sociology 2018, Ankur Gogoi. Anthropology 2019, Farzina Mezabin. Archaeology 2019, Darsana Deka. Economics 2019, Sandasmita Deka. Education 2019, Bhonita Kolita. History 2019, Wajida Ahmed. Philosophy 2019, Bhashyoti Talukdar. Political Science 2019, Sharmistha Chakraborty. Psychology 2019, Pratima Ekka. Sociology 2019, Ibha Kolita. BA in Anthropology, Economics, Education, History, Philosophy, Political Science of the years 2017, 2018, 2019. Anthropology 2017, Borokha Roy. Anthropology 2017, BSc, Pao Thang Len Singson. Economics 2017, Kritika Das. Economics 2017, Jigyasa Sandilya. Education 2017, Bhonita Kolita. History 2017, Kirtana Bordoloi. Philosophy 2017, Devojit Chakraborty. Political Science 2017, Krishangi Hoikia. Anthropology 2018, Angona Goswami. Anthropology 2018, BSc, Lolita Nath. Economics 2018, Karnika Bhattacharya. Economics 2018, BSc, Sopnalina Padgiri. Education 2018, Kaibboshri Hazorika. History 2018, Dorhona Bhuya. Philosophy 2018, Pompi Kolita. Political Science 2018, Megha Choudhury. Anthropology 2018, Hobita Devi. Anthropology 2019, Imon Ghosh. Economics 2019, Asim Nath. Economics 2019, Onneha Hoikia. Education 2019, Gautami Bezborua. History 2019, Bhavana Deka. Philosophy 2019, Bithika Roy. Political Science 2019, Diksha Bordoloi. PG Diploma in Mass Communication and Journalism 2017, Supriya Bora. 2018, Jutimoni Kolita. Faculty of Languages, Literature and Linguistics. MA in Arabic, Assamese, Bengali, Bodo, English, Hindi, Persian and Sanskrit of the years 2017, 2018, 2019. Arabic 2017, Shafiquzzaman Mustafa. Assamese 2017, Meenakshi Borua. Bengali 2017, Kea Laskar. English 2017, Sahnaz Saida Sultana. Hindi 2017, Risha Somua. Persian 2017, Minazul Haq. Sanskrit 2017, Owazasini Parasar. Arabic 2018, Mizanur Rahman. Assamese 2018, Borokharani Boisho. Assamese 2018, Risha Gogoi. Bengali 2018, Susitra Bera. English 2018, Gitika Talukdar. English 2018, Sikha Choudhury. Hindi 2018, Faridul Islam. Persian 2018, Samim Ahmed Laskar. Sanskrit 2018, Gaurismita Borua. Arabic 2019, Murtaza Hussein. Assamese 2019, Fancy Sutia. Assamese 2019, Purondo Gogoi. Bengali 2019, Hurobhi Debnath. English 2019, Mintu Nath. English 2019, Obhilasha Fukon. Hindi 2019, Nilakshi Pawe. Persian 2019, Salik Ahmed Laskar. Sanskrit 2019, Prajolita Chakraborty. BA in Arabic, Assamese, Bengali, Bodo, English, Hindi, Persian and Sanskrit of the years 2017, 2018, 2019. Assamese 2017, Fancy Sutia. Assamese 2017, Kritiman Choudhury. Bengali 2017, Devoshri Chakraborty. English 2017, Priyasna De. Hindi 2017, Himashri Nath. Sanskrit 2017, Jayashri Das. Arabic 2018, Khalid bin Saif. Assamese 2018, Dimpi Das. Bengali 2018, Mridul Nath. English 2018, Ananya Ghosh. Hindi 2018, Priyadarshini Das. Sanskrit 2018, Himadri Sharma. Arabic 2019, Muhammad Suruj Jamal. Assamese 2019, Mursana Bhattacharya. Bengali 2019, Raju Hutrodhar. English 2019, Rini Sultana. Hindi 2019, Jumi Choudhury. Sanskrit 2019, Risharani Sharma Kashyap. Faculty of Life Sciences, MSc in Botany, Environmental Biology and Wildlife Sciences, Molecular Biology and Biotechnology and Zoology of the years 2017, 2018, 2019. Botany 2017, Rajesh Dev Sarkar. Zoology 2017, Pushpanjali Khound. Botany 2018, Runa Rahman. Environmental Biology and Wildlife Sciences 2018, Omlan Aditya Goswami. Molecular Biology and Biotechnology 2018, Niharika Thakuria. Zoology 2018, Susmita Chakraborty. Botany 2019, Hagorika Pal. Environmental Biology and Wildlife Sciences, Manub Jyoti Talukdar. Molecular Biology and Biotechnology 2019, Puspa Sharma. Zoology 2019, Risha Sharma. BSc in Botany, Environmental Biology and Wildlife Sciences, Molecular Biology and Biotechnology, and Zoology of the years 2017, 2018, 2019. Botany 2017, Lipika Borua. Botany 2017, Hagorika Pal. Biotechnology 2017, Binita Dam. Zoology 2017, Nikita Jain. Botany 2018, Salini Deka. Biotechnology 2018, Ornob Saha. Zoology 2018, Amama Farzlin Farnaz. Botany 2019, Sutoshri Nath. Biotechnology 2019, Saurabh Sengupta. Zoology 2019, Diksha Kalita. Zoology 2019, Pranami Bharadwaj Bora. Faculty of Physical, Chemical and Mathematical Sciences, MSc in Chemistry, Computer Sciences and IT, Mathematics, MCA, Physics and Statistics of the years 2017, 2018, 2019. Chemistry 2017, Alpana Borua. Mathematics 2017, Hirokjyoti Bormon. MCA 2017, Abhijit Bonik. Physics 2017, Upahona Bordoloi. Statistics 2017, Shopon Bhattacharji. Chemistry 2018, Sakira Tabashum Bora. MCA 2018, Khuman Setia. Physics 2018, Sainas Parbin. Statistics 2018, Semantika Chakraborty. Chemistry 2019, Gargi Dutta. Mathematics 2019, Hourav Kumar Saha. MCA 2019, Shrutimala Deka. Physics 2019, Pinaki Dutta. Statistics 2019, Sayashri Sharma. BSc in Chemistry, Computer Science and IT, Mathematics, MCA, Physics and Statistics of the years 2017, 2018, 2019. Chemistry 2017, Anubrata Chakraborty. Computer Science 2017, Pallavi Goswami. Mathematics 2017, Hourav Kumar Saha. BCA 2017, Joy Krishna Das. Physics 2017, Kollol De. Statistics 2017, Kasturi Kashyap. Chemistry 2018, Ruby Moral. Computer Science 2018, Deep Protein Chakraborty. Mathematics 2018, Abhishek Goswami. BCA 2018, Shubham De. Physics 2018, Upama Das. Statistics 2018, Nilanjan Devnath. Chemistry 2019, Shreyosi Som. Computer Science 2019, Angshuman Sinha. Mathematics 2019, Anuhuya Boishya. BCA 2019, Devayan Chakraborty. Physics 2019, Jessica Ghatak.
May I now request Honorable Vice Chancellor Cotton University to proceed for the administration of the oath by this Chancellor.
I urge upon the candidates receiving the degrees of Cotton University to rise in their seats.
I charge you to take oath that you will henceforth behave in a manner that you will prove worthy of the degree conferred on you.
I now request Dhanjit Deka, who secured the highest CGPA in Master of Science Mathematics during the academic session 2016-18, to take oath on behalf of all graduating candidates in this convocation.
I do solemnly and sincerely declare that in my daily life I shall conduct myself in a manner that I prove worthy of the degree conferred on me today by Cotton University.
Moving on, we shall now have the convocation address to be delivered by our speaker, Professor Vinod Kumar Jain, Honorable Vice Chancellor, Tezpur University. We are honored to have the august presence of Honorable Vice Chancellor of Tezpur University, Professor Vinod Kumar Jain, amidst us today as the convocation speaker. An ex-professor at Jawaharlal Nehru University, New Delhi, and former Vice Chancellor, Doon University, Professor Jain is a distinguished academician who began his teaching career at Sussex University, UK, and served as a scientist at IIT New Delhi prior to taking up academics as his career and profession. He is an acclaimed researcher and eminent scientist, renowned both within India and abroad for his excellent contribution to the field of plasma physics and environmental sciences. He is also a member of several academic and statutory bodies as the UGC, CSIR, UPSC, among others. We extend our heartiest welcome to you, sir. May I now request Honorable Vice Chancellor, Cotton University, Professor Bhavesh Chandra Goswami, to take the proceedings forward.
I request Professor Vinod Kumar Jain, Vice Chancellor, Tezpur University, to deliver the convocation address.
His Excellency Professor Jagdish Mukhi, the Chancellor of Cotton University and Governor of the State of Assam, Dr. Himanta Biswa Sarma, the Honorable Chief Minister of Assam, Dr. Ranoj Pegu, the Honorable Education Minister of Assam, Professor B.C. Goswami, the Vice Chancellor, Cotton University, the Deans, Academic Council, the Executive Council, and Court members, the faculty members, the students, the parents, eminent guests, media persons, and ladies and gentlemen. It is such a huge privilege and honor that I address you on this very historic and auspicious occasion of the first convocation of Cotton University since its inception in 2017. I feel truly humbled and thankful to the university authorities and in particular Professor Goswami for providing me this opportunity to be with you in this convocation. I extend warm greetings and congratulations to all the graduating students who got their degrees in this convocation. Today, we must also acknowledge with gratitude the contributions of your parents and faculty whose efforts have played an enabling role in your academic achievements. As you move ahead in your career, whether you go for your higher studies or take up some job as a career in a highly competitive and globalized world, I'm confident that the skill sets which you have acquired at Cotton University are going to be very helpful in your future career. And this confidence of mine in you stems from the fact that Cotton University, earlier when it was a college, it was A++ grade college. That speaks volumes about the level of the academic standards in the college then, and I'm sure those standards are being maintained ever since this university came up in 2017. It's also very satisfying and heartening to know that the university has evolved into an institution of serious reckoning, not only in the Northeastern region, but also within the country. And I'm confident that few years down the line, when the NEC evaluation happens, the university is definitely going to get a very good grade, A+ or maybe better. So with this, I actually wish you the very best, the college authorities very best, the vice chancellor and his administration the very best in taking this university forward. Dear students, it must be a hugely proud moment for you, because now you will have an additional identity, that of a Cottonite. You have joined this very illustrious list of alumni of Cotton University. There have been, the most famous people from the erstwhile Cotton College who have done extremely well in all walks of life, whether it is politics. In fact, the current chief minister happens to be from Cotton University. Then two Bharat Ratnas and several very eminent academicians and literary figures which have come out from the Cotton College. So this is the moment you must cherish, that you are belonging to this very illustrious family of Cotton alumni. Dear students, now that you have graduated, the country is looking at you with a lot of expectations, because the youth in any country is considered as the engines and the drivers of the economic growth and development. And since you have, I'm sure, like anyone else, aspirations and desires to move up the ladder in your career, and combine that with your considerable talent and potential, this is going to make significant contribution to the general economic well-being of the nation. Realizing the huge potential that the youth of this country has, people like you have, the Indian government is hoping to have a $5 trillion economy in a few years' time. Now, this cannot come about easily. For that, the people like you and lots of young graduates from different institutions, including IITs and central universities, you have to compete with them and exploit the opportunities which the Indian government has provided to the young generation in terms of a very enabling innovation ecosystem, the startup ecosystem. So take advantage of that, and you don't necessarily have to go for conventional careers, whether in academics or engineering and what have you. You could, if you have good ideas, if you are creative, you can experiment with those ideas. And as I said, the country has a very enabling ecosystem for realizing your creative ideas. The dream of India 2.0, Ek Bharat, Shreshth Bharat, can be realized only if people like you contribute to this larger endeavor for making India a self-reliant country. This can happen only through innovation, as I said, innovation in startups, which hopefully would become one day truly multinational and perhaps unicorn entities. to thrive in today's innovation-driven ecosystem of world economy, you would agree that very diverse skill sets are required. Different kinds of competencies are required, along with some character attributes which are required to be successful in a very competitive world. The 21st century skills which have been identified by the World Economic Forum, they have, for example, in the list of competency, the critical thinking, the creativity, the communication and collaboration, and problem solving. So you have to act as a change agent by solving the problems which the society is facing. And at the same time, you have to develop some character attributes of honesty, of fairness, of grit, of determination, of resolve, so that you become more resilient to face any adverse situation, like which is prevailing in the country now because of this pandemic, or any adverse situation or any difficult situation which may arise in future. So a suitable mix of competencies, modern day competencies, I said 21st century competencies, along with some attributes which I just mentioned, are a prerequisite for you to succeed in this highly competitive and globalized world. Underpinning these competencies and these attributes, in fact, the government has come up with the new education policy, and that policy is designed to make India a knowledge and innovation economy. But at the same time, it also seeks to provide a value system which is based on our traditional Indian ethos of tolerance, of compassion, of kindness, and sensitivity to environment and to fellow beings. So this policy is going to actually enable you to update your skills much more than what you would do in a conventional academic programs. The government has come out with certain provisions like ABC, that is Academic Bank of Credit, and the guidelines have been issued also with respect to multiple entry and multiple exit through academic programs, which young people like you can use for updating your skills, acquiring more and more skills. Because if the situation so demands, you could move from one job to another job, or from a job to academics, and vice versa, from academics to job again, by availing these provisions in the new education policy. So a young person should strive to, as much as possible, to strive to update and upskill so that you move seamlessly from one career to another career. And this acquisition of the new skills would certainly make you more resilient, more confident, and this is what the country is expecting from people like you. May I just also remind you what the present government and especially our Prime Minister expects of the younger generation. In one of the addresses, in fact, when Prime Minister spoke in our convocation last year, he asked the students to dream what kind of India they would like to see in year 2047, 100 years down the line from 1947. And that's the kind of India you should have in mind, and you pursue that dream by making efforts towards that end. So may I just appeal to all of you to do your best as much as you can, to the best of your ability, to the extent possible, make an honest effort, make a sincere effort to contribute to this larger picture of country's well-being, country's economic growth, and make India maybe one of the top three economies of the world. I would conclude by quoting the Prime Minister, who said very recently that for us, essence of history and faith is sabka saath, sabka vishwas, sabka prayas, and sabka vikas. So let us join hands together in making India a truly knowledge and innovation economy, as well as do our best to make India a very inclusive society where every citizen lives a life of dignity. So with this hope that you would do extremely well in your future career, I wish you the very best. Thank you. Thank you so much for giving me this opportunity to be with you in this auspicious convocation. Thank you so much.
I request guest of honor, Dr. Ranoj Pegu, Honorable Education Minister, Assam, to deliver his address.
Honorable Governor of Assam and the Chancellor of Cotton University, Professor Jagdish Mukhiji, Honorable Chief Minister of Assam, Dr. Himanta Biswa Sarma Dangoria, a respected Professor Binod Kumar Jain, Vice Chancellor of Tezpur University, a respected Professor Bhavesh Chandra Goswami, the Vice Chancellor of Cotton University, a respected members of Cotton University Court, Executive Council, Academic Council, Deans, Alumni, and the Registrar, Professor Diganta Kumar Das Dangoria, my dear students, ladies and gentlemen. Amidst COVID pandemic, on this auspicious occasion of convocation of Cotton University, I congratulate all the members of Cotton University family on this occasion, the first convocation of Cotton University, and I wish a bright future ahead to all the students who have been awarded degrees and diplomas in this convocation. We all know that Cotton College, established in 1901, the first temple of higher learning of Northeast India, was upgraded to Cotton University in the year 2017 with a vision under this Cotton University Act of 2017. Cotton College played a very pivotal role in enlightening the people of the entire Northeast India with the light of knowledge. The alumni and of the pride of Northeast India, Cotton College, had been rendering their services in different fields, not only in the country, but also at different locations, different corners of the globe. I hope that Cotton University shall also play the same role in producing valued human resources in the days to come. The government of Assam, particularly soon after upgrading the Cotton College to a Cotton University, have been trying to extend all sorts of help and cooperation to the Cotton University for its growth. We must recall our very innovative scheme of the then Education Minister, now Honorable Chief Minister of Assam, Dr. Himanta Biswa Sarma, that is Tejasvi Navodhitamastu program, by which he offered very generously to all the universities, all the institutions of higher education, particularly in the field of infrastructure development. And under this Tejasvi Navodhitamastu program, funds were provided for the administrative building of Cotton University. Funds were also provided for construction of boys' hostel, renovation of Kalaguru Vishnu Rava Hall, construction of students' day home, that is under Rusha, which are almost near completion, as I am told, and I am very happy about it. The government of Assam, I assure, shall continue to extend its support to Cotton University for all-around development. We all know we have this new education policy now, and there is going to be a very paradigm shift of our education system, education policy. The government of Assam has already constituted Rajyik Shiksha Ayuk as per recommendation of the new education policy. And we have also constituted the Empowered Committee for Higher Education, Empowered Committee for School Education, and we are beginning to implement the new education policy. Particularly in the higher education, we are going to de-link the class 11 and 12, that is the secondary school part, from the colleges. And this will be done in a phased manner. We have already established several new universities where we are focusing to implement the new education policy from the very beginning. This India-centric new education policy, it emphasizes on digitalization of the education system. And I am appealing to all the universities to have their own ERP, own digital system of teaching, learning, and overall management of the university. In higher education, we have started digitalization of our higher education directorate under the department. And this pandemic situation, in one way, it is an opportunity for us to join the Digital India March and completely transform our record keeping, our management and all into a digital mode. And I hope the Cotton University will contribute in a great way to this digitalization of our education system. The flexibility, the versatility that is being talked about the multidisciplinary approach of our curriculum and all these things are being discussed already in several fora, particularly under the initiative of our Honorable Governor. There was a Vishi conference, and very soon we are going to hold another round of discussion with all the Vice Chancellors for implementation of the new education policy. I seek cooperation from all the universities. There is another scheme the government of Assam has taken up, that is the reconstruction, redevelopment, rejuvenation of our heritage institution. And when we talk about the heritage institution, naturally the name of Cotton College, it comes first. There are many high schools, higher secondary schools, which were established during the British period. And these high schools, higher secondary schools contributed to a great extent in producing human resources, and we have decided to rejuvenate all these heritage institutions. And there are many heritage buildings in Cotton University, and I appeal to the university authority to restore all these heritage buildings, so that whenever we visit this university, this edifices, and with the memories of the old days, it comes back. And we have also decided to invite all the alumni, because alumni, that they play a very important role in development course of the educational institutions. Our Honorable Chief Minister has recently, during the last Independence Day speech, he appealed to everyone to revisit their schools, revisit their educational institutions which educated them. So I on this auspicious occasion of the convocation, I appeal to all the alumni of Cotton College, erstwhile Cotton College and now Cotton University, to revisit this great institution and contribute in whatever way possible for the growth of this Cotton University. And this is a clarion call by the government, by our Honorable Chief Minister. My dear students, today you have been awarded with degrees and diplomas in different disciplines. The degree, the diploma that you have earned today shall help you to get a job in the job market. But apart from seeking the job in the job market, we should also be thinking about to become job creator, and that we can become only by taking up entrepreneurship. So with your degree and diploma, if some of you can come forward as entrepreneur and as a job creator and start some startups, which can show a new road for our upcoming generation. And I hope the students who have just received their degrees, diplomas from this Cotton University, they will also contribute in this way to be by becoming entrepreneur, by becoming job creator and instead of job seeker. And finally, I once again congratulate the students who have been awarded degrees, diplomas in this convocation, and I wish them to serve the society of our country sincerely and honestly. I wish that Cotton University shall carry forward its glory, its legacy in the coming years. With permission of Honorable Governor and Chancellor of the Cotton University, I conclude and thank you very much.
I request the Chief Guest, Dr. Himanta Biswa Sarma, Honorable Chief Minister, Assam, to deliver his address.
Honorable Governor of Assam and Chancellor of Cotton University, Professor Jagadish Mukhi, Sri Ranoj Pegu, Minister of Education, Government of Assam, Professor Binod Kumar Jain, Vice Chancellor, Tezpur University, Professor Bhavesh Chandra Goswami, Vice Chancellor, Cotton University, Members of Cotton University Court, Executive Council and Academic Council, Faculty Members, Invited Guests, Alumni, and my dear graduating students and their proud parents. It is indeed a privilege to welcome all of you to this august occasion. This is for the first time that Cotton University is organizing its convocation after both Cotton College and Cotton University truly merged into one institution. We are meeting on this occasion in virtual mode due to the current pandemic situation. Needless to mention that the impact of COVID-19 has come as a shock to humanity. However, in spite of the present situation, we must look beyond the pandemic to the potential in the post-COVID world and walk hand in hand to discover the silver linings in this crisis to build a more prosperous society. Cotton University, considering its rich history, should come forward to take the responsibility on offering a new perspective of post-pandemic future. On this occasion, I pay my tributes to the leading actors who played important role in getting this college established in Assam. My heartiest tribute to Revered Manik Chandra Borua, one of the most eminent leaders of the then Assam. It was under his leadership that the agitation for establishment of a college took a decisive momentum that finally resulted in the successful manifestation of the long series dream for a college in Assam. On this occasion, my heartfelt reverence to Sir Henry Cotton, the then Chief Commissioner, who was also instrumental for the establishment of this college way back in 1901, which sowed the seeds of higher education in our state. It was in this year the journey of higher education in modern Assam began. During the last 120 years of its existence, Cotton College made a position for itself. The Cotton University Act 2017 provides ample opportunities for this great institution to grow and expand its horizon. However, this university needs new outlook, thoughts and ideas that match with the contemporary as emphasized by the National Education Policy 2020. The world is now undergoing rapid changes in the knowledge landscape. With various scientific and technological advances, many unskilled jobs worldwide may be taken over by machines, while the need for a skilled workforce in conjunction with multidisciplinary abilities across the sciences, social sciences and humanities will be in greater demand. The growing emergence of epidemics and pandemics will also call for a collaborative research in infectious disease management and in the resultant socio-economic issues. There will be a growing demand for humanities and art along with science and technologies as India moves towards becoming a developed country as well as among the three largest economies in the world. The National Education Policy 2020 is the first education policy of the 21st century, which aims to address many growing development imperatives of our country. The policy proposed to create a new system that is aligned with the aspiration of 21st century education, building upon India's tradition and value system. This signifies allowing the indigenous knowledge system to become part of mainstream narrative. Indigenous knowledge system includes knowledge from our ancient India and its contribution to modern India and its success and challenges, specific courses in ethno-medicinal practices, forest management, organic crop cultivation, natural farming, etc., need to be brought from the oblivion and made part of the mainstream education. This all-inclusive character of this education policy has made us feel rather hopeful, especially in view of the fact that Assam is the treasure trove of powerful traditional knowledge and immense natural resources. Moreover, the policy lays emphasis on higher education, significantly contributing towards sustainable livelihood and economic development of the nation. The Cotton University, being a frontline institute of higher education, should take the lead in promoting local or traditional knowledge. The university should take steps in preserving and adding value to ancient textual material, manuscript in classical Indian languages. It should also take a lead in disseminating research of Indian knowledge system into cutting-edge professional development programs. Today, the Cotton University is running with 31 departments, 245 faculty members, and more than 5,000 students. The infrastructure is ramping up to meet the ever-increasing requirement. There are constant demand for upgradation of infrastructure, achieving academic excellence, introduction of innovative courses, raising confidence of the learners, and making optimism the mainstay of the system. I assure, in the days to come, all steps will be taken to fulfill such aspiration of the academic community. I am extremely happy to congratulate all the gold medalists and all other students who have been admitted and awarded degrees in this convocation. You are already awakened to the realities of intense competition. You have acquired capacity to take advantage of competitive environment. While you may use this capacity to create wealth and welfare for the organization you work for, it is also your duty to strive for welfare of the society, for reducing disparity and empower those who are disadvantaged. I congratulate all the students for receiving their degree in the convocation today, and I wish you all success in your future. With these words, I conclude my speech. Jai Hind, Bande Mataram.
I request the Chancellor, Professor Jagdish Mukhi, His Excellency, Honorable Governor of Assam, to deliver his address.
Respected Chief Guest of the Convocation, Chief Minister Dr. Hemanta Vishwa Sharma Ji, Guest of Honor, Minister of Education Dr. Ranuj Pegu Ji, Speaker of the Convocation, Vice Chancellor, Tejpur University, Professor Vinod Kumar Jain Ji, Vice Chancellor, Cotton University, Professor Bhavesh Chandra Goswami ji, members of University Court, members of the Academic Council, Registrar, heads of the departments and centers, faculty members, and most importantly, all graduating students and their parents. It is with a sense of pride that I address and congratulate a global audience of graduating students and their families on this date of the first convocation of Cotton University. While we may be in the midst of a global pandemic, I am sure that you all have already been prepared by the transformative educational philosophy of Cotton University to navigate these uncertain times with the fortitude and resolve. I also understand that you would have been looking forward to this momentous convocation ceremony at your campus with your friends and families cheering for you as you receive your degrees. However, this has not been possible because of the pandemic. Let's also remember the millions across the globe who are affected by COVID pandemic. The pandemic has created the largest disruption of education in history, affecting billions of students across the world. Therefore, today, the meaning of your education manifests in becoming more intellectually competent, morally upright, socially committed, spiritually inspired, more than ever before. This is required to put the disrupted pieces back together again to create a more evolved and harmonious whole. It is my privilege to preside over the first convocation of the university. I am told that 3,908 students are going to receive their degrees and diplomas at this convocation. I heartily congratulate all of you on your achievement and wish you all a bright future. A university is a depository of knowledge, and it molds human resources of a country for generations. In its journey into future, the institution continues to imbibe its rich experience from the past while producing human minds for the future. A university ought to aim towards making the task of knowledge delivery an intensive exercise to make the students intellectually and spiritually empowered. The Gandhian definition of education, which stresses the all-round development of the individual, remains a benchmark even in the contemporary context. I firmly believe that Cotton University shall set an example by creating such human resources in the days to come. I congratulate one and all today when Cotton University is having its first convocation for the academic sessions 2017-2019. I am happy to learn that the university has its roots in the 116 years old Cotton College that was established in 1901 in Guwahati when Sir Henry Stedman Cotton was the chief commissioner of Assam province under the British government. Since those days, it has proudly withstood the test of time by confronting every challenge to become a center of excellence in the task of generating worthy citizens for this great country of ours. The academic environment of the country today anticipates a radical transformation in view of the National Education Policy 2020, which intends to provide a holistic foundation for life that embraces academics and non-academic spheres. Therefore, task of Cotton University, I believe, should be the force multiplier in total application of new education policy to bring about a paradigm shift in the education in our life. It is needless to mention that technology has become omnipresent in every sphere of life. Education is not an exception. The prevalence of technology in education has become more visible in the wake of a COVID pandemic. In this context, I should make it a point that institutions should, however, keep in mind that technology should be utilized to bring about inclusive, equitable, and qualitative information in accordance with the NEP framework. In keeping with the new education policy, Cotton University should design roadmap for the future so that it can march along with the rest of the country in the field of education. It should take steps not only to cater to the needs of its immediate members, but also play a vital role in transforming the society at large through its extension services. I am happy that Cotton University has moved in this direction by introducing several programs and courses which are multidisciplinary and interdisciplinary nature. With over 30 departments and a student strength that exceeds several thousands at present, the university possesses a vibrant academic community comprising its students and faculty, authority and institutional governance, all making their best efforts in their respective capacities to keep pace with the changing scenario. The institution has also been actively participating in social responsibility engagements and has achieved commendable success in the field of education and community health. It is indeed immensely heartening to know that Cottonians have been playing crucial roles in cultural, social, political, and sporting arena to bring laurels of all hues. In its glorious journey to the present, this premier institution has charted a growth trajectory that is simply impressive. The proud alumni of this institution include the eminent bard of the Brahmaputra, Bharat Ratna Dr. Bhupendra Hazarika, Chief Scientist of India's Chandrayaan Mission 1, Professor Jitendra Nath Goswami, internationally acclaimed Ramayana scholar Dr. Mamoni Raisom Goswami, the present Chief Minister of our state Dr. Hemant Vishwa Sharma. The list is endless. Dear students, the onus of continuing and enriching this enviable legacy lies with the present generation of Cottonians. On this occasion, may I call upon our students' fraternity to imbibe the spirit of curiosity, develop scientific temper to face all the challenges of the world in the 21st century. I hope that the brand Cotton shall continue its glorious march into future and be the torch bearer in all respects by showing the path of transformation in a positive dimension that moves beyond education. I would like to end by quoting Mahatma Gandhi. He once said, "Be the change that you wish to see in this world." So I say to you all, lead the world, be the change, and make Assam and India proud. Thank you. Jai Hind.
I request the Honorable Chancellor to declare the convocation closed.
I declare the first convocation of Cotton University closed.
May I now request all to rise for the national anthem.
Janagana mana adhinayaka jaya he Bharat bhagya vidhata Punjab Sindh Gujarat Maratha Dravida Utkala Vanga Vindhya Himachala Yamuna Ganga Uchala Jaladhi Taranga तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मांगे गाहे तव जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे।